You're up in the sky, from that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it, I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope, when my back's against the ropes, I can feel it.
Hey, I want to thank you guys for having me here. I just want to get right into this. I want you to raise your hand in this room right now if you have a mentor. Raise your hand real high. Okay, now I want you to keep your hands up if your mentor is in this room right now. Everybody look around. Look at them right now. Look at them. Their mentor's in this room right now. All right, you can put your hands down. See, because I know something about you. You got a secret. Yeah, y'all don't think we know it. You don't think I know it or people in this room know it. But we know it. You got a secret. It's written all over your face. Look at you. Don't try to hide. Look at you. See, you got a secret. I know something about you that other people don't know. See, you've been cheating. Yeah, you've been cheating on your mentor. Look at your mentor right now. Look at him, the chest all out. They saw you raise your hand. They were so proud. They had no idea what you've been doing. They had no idea that you've been looking at another. You got a secret. But you see, today we're going to share your secret. I'm going to tell some folk. And don't be ashamed. Don't be embarrassed, because it could happen to a lot of us. But see, you got a secret. See, your mentor don't know it, but I know that you've been watching this other person from afar. I know you've been checking her out. You've been watching her, wondering if she could be all that they said she was, that she served as a school board, a Girl Scout board member, and a council delegate, and participated in numerous community-wide services. You got a secret. You've been watching this other person for years, watching as she was a TTA National Spelling Bee champion and a United Way's Mayor's Youth Award winner. You got a secret. You've been checking her out as she did all these different things, and she graduated magna cum laude at Judson High School with a GPA out of this world, and she had 20 scholarships and $160,000 presidential scholarship at Tulane University. You got a secret. But it's not so much a secret anymore right now. Because a lot of people in this room, they now know that this young lady went on to Tulane and did so many things, like stood up a chapter of the NAACP right there on campus and was put in for all kinds of awards. You got a secret. But we may as well put it all out there now, guys, because see, you're not the only ones. Even some of your mentors got this same secret. So why don't we all just give a big round of applause to Sharice Amanda Cochran for all the incredible things she did and how she inspired us. Give her a big round of applause. Let the angels in heaven hear you and wonder what in the world's going on down there in San Antonio. You see, it's okay, guys. It's okay to have that secret, because look at this room. This girl's purpose, I don't know what it was exactly, but look at what she's done even not being here. See, what I know is that your mentor don't always have to have skin on them right now. You know, I'm following folk who are long gone, just like we're following this young lady 10 years after she passed away. I just hope and pray, we all should hope and pray, that 10 years after we're gone home to be with God, that people would be gathering somewhere, remembering us, talking about the impact we made on their lives. So again, keep that in mind as we talk for the rest of this day, because I want you to understand why we're here and what the reason we're here. If she had not passed away, we would not be doing the incredible things we're doing today. So your secret is safe with us. I want to thank all of you for having me. I want to thank Claudette for trusting me enough for this incredible event. This was special. I want to recognize the rest of you. Yes, we talk about Sharice. Yes, we talk about Claudette, and we'll talk about her some more. But I want to talk about even some of you guys in here, the people who've been a part of this program for years and been volunteering, and the board members. You guys have made this big difference. This thing wouldn't happen without all of you. So you should all be so, so very proud. I know I had to be here. I just know I did. And I couldn't have got paid. She couldn't have paid me. I didn't want money from her. I wanted to be a part of this. I even donated 20 of my books so that you guys know this is so, so important. Too important than I do. So as I thought about what I was going to say, I said, imagine, Nippy, if Sharice could speak to you from heaven right now, from the presence of God, what would she say? Now, I've never met the young lady, but from what I've read about her, I know that Sharice would say, never listen to little me. And you say, who is little me? I'm glad you asked that. Who is little me? I see the look on your face. See, little me is that little voice inside you that tells you you can't do something, that you're not tall enough or smart enough or black enough or white enough or woman enough or man enough or talented enough or skilled enough or good enough in math or so forth and so on. That's that little voice in you that tells you, who do you think you are that you're trying to do such and such? That's that voice that too many of us in this room listen to too many times. And so Charisse would tell you, never listen to that voice. I know she didn't. She couldn't have accomplished all she did had she listened to little me. Instead, she probably listened to future me. Future me is that voice that tells you down the road. It comes and it tells you, thank you for what you did a year ago. Thank you for what you did a month ago. Thank you for the decision you made a week ago. Those things that you said or did back then got us to the point where we are today. And so what you want to do is start listening to future me and imagine, if you will, anytime you're about to, at a crossroad about to make a decision, what would future me tell you a year from now, 2 months from now, a week from now, if you make the decision to do something that little me is trying to stop you from doing? Well, see, both of us have a little me and a future me in us. Which one are you listening to? So what I have is a video I want to show you, because see, for as mentors in this room, you need to understand that the words you say are so important to your mentee or your protege or your protege. But more importantly, what you do or don't do in front of them is just as important, because they're watching you. They're listening, but they're also watching you. And so they're scared sometimes. They don't know what to do. They got that fear, that false evidence appearing real. And so what I want to do is show you a video. And in this video, it's a little girl on the top of a ski slope, and she's terrified. And I want to listen. I want you to hear it as the mentor is trying to talk to the mentee and help her to do something she can't do without that mentor. And you have the same thing going on with you. So just hang on. I want you to listen to this, and we'll come right back. So you've got to understand that this could happen to you and your mentee and mentor.
I'll be fine.
Come on.
I'll do it. Well, here goes something, I guess. Okay, you can do this. I'm gonna jump.
You got it.
Whoa, my ski's slipping off.
Just remember, never snowplow, okay?
No snowplows.
Keep it straight, you'll be fine.
Okay.
You can be on the 20.
Straight. Do you go faster on the in run?
A little bit.
A little bit?
Yeah.
Is it any steeper, do you think? Not
same,
much?
Same steepness, it's just longer.
Well, just longer. Just longer. Just a bigger 20, that's all.
Yep. That's
it's
gone.
A bigger 20.
Go ahead.
I got it.
It's fine. You'll be fine.
Okay. Here.
The longer you wait, you'll be more scared.
I go. At the top of the first time freaks me out. That's the only thing. It's so fun. Huh? 60 seems like nothing now.
Yeah, wasn't that incredible? So think about it. Listen to that euphoria that she had when she was screaming at the end. She was so excited, ready to go do it again. But if you heard up top, there was not just the mentor, but there was that little voice too. Then the longer you wait, the scarier it gets. See, that's like another little mentee talking to another mentee. Sometimes you guys can encourage each other. So that fear that we talked about, that don't let that little me stop you from doing that thing that can change your life, but more importantly, the lives of so many around you. So her future me would have told her that had she not listened to little me, and she would have gone straight down that slope right away. So back to Charisse. If Charisse could talk to us right now, see, she can't release her future me and due to her untimely passing 10 years ago. But what would she tell us today if she could speak to us today? She would tell us to unlock that future me in each of us as we fulfill God's purpose in each of our lives, especially in the teens that we mentor. So, like the girl in the video, like she said, the sooner you get her down that hill, the better she'll feel so she can go do it again. The sooner she can become what God intends for her to be. So, for a mentor, Claudette has set such an incredible example for all of us. I used to tell her when she used to talk to me about, Nippy, I want you to be a mentor to some of my kids. And I'm like, Claudette, I'm too busy to mentor. I got all these things going on. Claudette, no, no, no. Even though she was like a freaking warrior the way she did her stuff. And I guess she looked at me like this young kid who, how could you be so busy? I'm doing 20 things and you're doing this one. You have time for this. And I never thought I did until I realized that I was a mentor to kids. I was helping kids. So I was already doing what Claudette was trying to tell me to do. I just didn't codify it. I didn't look at it like that. And so what I want us to do is be more like Claudette. She was a selfless warrior, and she went out and she made a difference in so many teens' lives. I look at what people say about her. I read what people wrote about her. And I'm just saying, this lady is tenacious. So Claudette, I know that you, although you're not here, I know that you're here with us in spirit. I know you're home burying your mother. But I want you to know something. We all respect and admire you so much. Charisse, if she was here today, would tell you, Mama, you are awesome. Your children, they believe in you. They know that you have that vision and that passion. So we're all proud of you for your tenacity and for your organizational skill. Now, this organization has been around for a while. And Claudette's getting a little older, just like me. She doesn't move as fast as she used to. She doesn't talk as fast. And so she needs some warriors to step up and take that baton. She needs somebody to come in and say, hey, Claudette, sit on the side. Let me run for a while. And so you're in this room right now. And it doesn't matter what name's on the top of the thing up here, whether it's Charisse, Amanda Cochran, or whatever. What this organization is doing is changing lives. And so if you're a part of this organization already, tell her, I'm ready. Put me in, Coach Claudette. I'm ready. I'm ready. Put me in the game. Give her some rest so she can recharge her battery a little bit. And that'll help this organization grow even further. Now, I know something about little me. EP21's been around now. This is our 9th year. We're going to have our 10-year anniversary next year. And little me tried to stop me. Little me tried to stop me from doing EP21 9 years ago. But future me is already saying, thank you, Nippy. Thank you, because now we have a TV show that we didn't have back then. Now we have a book that we have written. Now you're a sought-after paid speaker. Now you have a regional platform as a scholarship guru. And little me used to tell me, who gonna listen to you anyway? You ain't nobody. You're just a little fat man who has a daughter in high school. Who's gonna listen to you? But future me said, don't listen to that stuff. Future me stretched me beyond my imagination. And now after I've done all the things that I've done and all the things that I just told you I've succeeded at, future me still stretches me. He now says that I'm a teenologist. He now says that I'm an ignition catalyst, that I'm trying to help millennials and so forth reach inside and ignite what's inside of them. You know, and so I'm sitting there thinking, wait a minute, what is teenology anyway, future me? I don't even know what that is. It's that science of dealing with teens and all of their issues. But little me says, no, you're just a scholarship guy. So all of a sudden, now little me's trying to tell me I'm a scholarship guy because he don't want me to go and succeed in this other stuff. But future me said, no, you help teens prepare for life after high school. It's way bigger than just scholarships. It's way bigger than just that simple thing. So I'm sitting there and I'm moving forward, listening to future me who started me into this other thing called Scholarships for All. Now, God has given me a new business that will allow me to fulfill my purpose more abundantly. And he's done it with a concept that's just crazy. And so the best way to describe it to you is like this. I'm going to help kids just like I've been doing with EP21, and I will continue to do with EP21 and my TV show. But for Scholarships for All, besides helping people for free, I want you to think about a charter boat analogy, because this is what future me told me. He said, Nippy, in Scholarships for All, you're like a charter boat captain. And I can relate to that because I go out all the time here in San Antonio with Captain Steve. We go to Canyon Lake and there's a lot of people. I talked about like one of my coworkers, Wanda. Wanda don't catch any fish. She go to Canyon Lake all the time and she doesn't catch any fish. But when I go out there, I hang them. I catch all kinds of fish. The reason I catch fish is because I go out there with a guy, Captain Steve, who knows where to go to get the fish. He knows where to go, where the spots are, what bait to use, how deep to put your lines in the water. He knows all that. Yeah, now those people on the bank, they might catch a fish here and there, and he might even tell them some tricks. But they don't catch the fish like me and Captain Steve catch. And so that's what I'm trying to make people understand with Scholarships for All, is I'm like a charter boat fisherman when it comes to scholarships. You get in my boat. You come with me. I will take you out there where there are scholarships. I will help you become like Joy Stevens, who was in my program, who got $1.2 million. I'll help you like I'm helping Jason Collins right now, who've already applied for 125 scholarships this year. I will help you like so many of the teens in my program who go to Yale and Stanford and UT and Davidson and so forth and so on. They're at all these great schools in Notre Dame. They're there and they're on full paid scholarships. I got kids getting money back. I'm good at what I do. Nobody does me like I do me when it comes to helping kids. There ain't nobody out there who can do it like that. I know that. Future me has told me that. Future me has already told me where we're going with this. Little me, I've kicked little me to the curb. There will be those people who will say, Nippy, Nippy, you're trying to make money on those kids. Nippy, look at you now. Why are you doing this for money? Here's the deal. There are people who are offering me money every year. $5,000 to help this kid. $4,000 to help this kid. $3,500 to help this kid for just 3 months. These people want me to help them. I keep saying, no, 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 I don't do this for money. Just bring them to EP21. We don't want to bring them to EP21. We want you to help them. We want to pay you to help them. So I've turned that down over and over and over again. And so what I'm starting to realize is it's that same thing with that guy in the flood that they talk about. When the water was coming up and the guy was at the house and the people came by, knocked on the door and said, hey, come on, get in the car. We got to go. The flood water's coming. He said, no, God will take care of me. And then the water kept coming and the rain kept falling. The water kept coming up and he got to the second floor. Somebody came in a boat and they said, come on, let's go. And he said, no, no, God will take care of me. And so water kept coming up and up and up and the water kept flowing down from the sky. The guys on the roof, helicopters come by and they said, come on, sir, grab the ladder. And the guy says, no, 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 God will take care of me. And so the guy drowns. He gets up to heaven, and when he gets up there in front of God, he says, God, why did you let me drown? I trusted you. I trusted that you would stop me. You wouldn't let me drown. You would protect me. And God said, who do you think sent the car and the boat and the helicopter? It was God. And so that's what I look at with the people with the $5,000 and the $4,000 and the $3,500. That $3,500 was that last helicopter coming down and say, Nippy, grab here. And I said, no, I've been begging God to give me a way so that I can go work with kids full time and I don't have to work this six-figure job that I'm working. And he's given me a way. He's given me the specialized knowledge and the imagination to go out and create and do something different that I couldn't do yesterday, but I can do tomorrow based on the information I know today. And it's about finding those kids out there who are willing to pay a little small amount every month, a very small amount, not thousands, but I mean very small amount. And so if they pay me that very small amount and I got enough of that, I could then stop working and I can help more kids for free because I don't have to worry about that 40-hour-a-week job. And so I'm not going to listen to little me who tells me that people are going to think I'm being greedy or I'm trying to make money. Little me, get out of my face. I don't care about that. Because I know what God has put inside of me and he's trying to get me to do. And so I'm going to be obedient and do what he said to do so that I can go help more kids. Again, that's what I'm going to do. And I'm not going to listen to the negativity of people around me who say anything different. I will still do EP21. I will still do the TV show. Even with Scholarships for All, I will still help kids for free. But I will also help kids who want me to personally help them more so they can do things tomorrow they couldn't do yesterday because they met me today. And so what's happening is we go out there and we help these kids get those big scholarships in Scholarships for All. And that's what we're doing. And it's a mastermind where I'm going to group kids together searching for money, searching for that stuff so they can make a difference in their life and change their future. So I don't listen to that crap that little me talks about. Little me says nobody in San Antonio will support my program. Future me says even Jesus left home to fulfill his purpose, so I'm going to leave San Antonio and travel around the country to help kids as well. Little me says my friends are telling me that I shouldn't do this and I should not give up a good thing and a guaranteed income that I have with my job. But future me says my purpose is 10 months pregnant. I have got to get this thing out of me. I'm 10 months pregnant and I'm about to explode. And so I gotta get this out of me. This thing that God has put in me is not to stand inside of me. And so even if I gotta make less money in order to go do what God meant for me to do, that's what I'm gonna do. So welcome to the delivery room. You're watching me right now give birth little me kill tells me, you can't do this by yourself. That's okay. I don't have to do it by myself. Even Jesus needed a crew. So I'll have people and we'll run together. And so we're going to welcome to my delivery room. Like I say, right now, this day, with God on my side, I don't care what my dad says, my wife says. It doesn't matter. I'm going to give birth to what God has put inside of me so that I can go out and help people. He's put this passion inside of me. I feel like the sun. I'm about to explode. Just like with Sharice Cochran, when this thing happened and they started this foundation with Claudette, when they started this thing, it's like you guys gravitated around that thing like the sun, and kids just gravitated. And that's what's happening. I feel like that same thing. So Sharice would tell little me, shut up right now. Shut up, little me. Stop fulfilling your purpose, is what she would say, while you're able to do so. While you're here on this side of heaven, start fulfilling your purpose today. She'd say, shut up, little me. I can do it. Shut up, little me. I'm more than a conqueror. Shut up, little me. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Shut up, little me. God is my strength and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? See, like me, a lot of you guys in this room right now, today, you're pregnant. It's time for you to give birth to whatever God is calling you to do or say. This is your season. People out there are waiting for your gifts. They're waiting for your gifts to manifest in you. So you're now in the delivery room of your life today, right now, this Saturday. What is it? Not a boy. Not a girl. But maybe it's a dream. Maybe it's a book you've been trying to write. Maybe it's a degree you've been trying to get. Maybe it's a business that you need to start, that somebody's out there waiting for you to do. Don't die with God's gift inside of you. That would be so selfish. Chase your dream down by listening to Future Me today. God bless each of you. Have a great day. Stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky. I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it. I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope. When my back's against the ropes, I can feel it. I'm the world's greatest. The world's greatest, y'all. The world's greatest. Ever. I am a giant. I am an eagle. Oh, I am a lion. Down in the jungle. I am a marching band. I am the people. Oh, I am a helping hand. I am a hero. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky. I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it.